Good morning. It's Thursday, March 7th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are above fair value, so we are looking for a higher open at 9:30 Thursday morning. The futures have been up all morning. They popped a little in the past few minutes. Dow futures currently up about 40 points, so we're definitely getting a higher open this morning. Yesterday, we saw a big pop in Brazil. Of course, the change in government in Venezuela could have a positive impact on their relationship with Brazil. Overnight, the Australian market made a new high, but closed lower on the day. Both Hong Kong and Shanghai were down a little, while we saw a slight up move in the Nikkei, but making a new high for this move. Looking at the U.S. market, confidence is low that we're going to be able to move much higher from here. It's getting pretty thin up here. Bonds moved down yesterday, actually generated a sell signal. So we've got bonds back on a sell signal. That could support higher stock prices. Certainly, the market has been able to move higher even with a higher U.S. dollar and a lower euro, and those could start to change direction today. We're getting some news out of Europe. The Canadian dollar, which would be the risk-on trade, of course, is continuing to have problems here. So not a lot of love for commodities at the moment. Looking at the major indexes, starting with the S&P 500, very small range bar yesterday. The volumes that we're seeing right now, and I'm looking at the SPDR ETF, you can see the volumes have been decreasing over the past few days. According to Yahoo, the average volume per day is 134 million shares and change, and we haven't done that in the last 3 days. So we've got below average volumes up here, so the air is getting pretty thin. You're getting a lot less people active up at these levels. And even though the markets were up yesterday, the VIX for the S&P 500 was also up. And so options traders not that enthusiastic right now that this market's going to be able to go higher. And we had a bearish reversal day for the NASDAQ 100, and the VIX for the NASDAQ 100 also moved up yesterday. So the VIX index, or the fear index, you know, if these options traders were enthusiastic about what was going to happen next, then we would see the premium, options premiums continue to decline, but that is not the case at the moment. Bank stocks moved up over the past couple of days, and so all the major bank stocks are back on buy signals. Bank of America, Citigroup, JP Morgan, Wells Fargo, they're all up on buy signals once again. The gold sector had a nice pop yesterday, still on a sell signal, came up to the lower channel line. We've got a couple of stocks that are back on buy signals, but it's only a couple of stocks. Certainly not a time and place to be buying this sector. So Freeport had a nice move up yesterday. Goldcorp is also back on a buy signal, but most of the other stocks are still on sell signals, so no change there. Looking at my five stocks, Apple Computer down again yesterday, no change there. No change for the CME Group, continue to move higher. Google had a bearish reversal day, so we'll have to see if we get fall through to the downside on Thursday. Goldman Sachs still on a buy signal, no change there. And Visa had an inside day on Wednesday. Take a look at commodities, certainly no changes in trend on Wednesday. If copper is the global economic barometer, it's certainly not going in the right direction. If you look back 4 days, you can see we had a big range bar down. We were looking to see if we could move up and take out that high. That hasn't happened yet. We haven't taken out the low either, so it's an inside week so far, and looking to see if we take out that low on Thursday. 343.75 is our next target to the downside if we take out that low. A lot of people excited about gold and gold stocks right now. You know, is this the time and place to buy? So far, we don't have anything positive happening in the gold for the price of gold. We need to close on Thursday above 1599.36 to give us a buy signal. And the better bet might be silver. We need to close above 2916 to give us a buy signal on Thursday. Looking at energy, no change for crude oil, no change for gasoline. If gasoline can take out the recent high, then a move up to 332 would be our next target. Looking at heating oil, moved up to the lower channel line yesterday, still on a sell signal. And as we've mentioned a couple of times this week, natural gas having trouble getting out above the January highs. It's now trading back down to the upper trend line. Still on a buy signal, still bullish here. If we start trading back in the channel, then of course things start to change. Last up this morning, quick look at some 60-minute charts. The VIX is still below the flypaper channel, which is bullish for the stock market. First sign of weakness for the stock market is going to be the VIX above 1374. S&P 500, this is, of course, 60-minute panic zone chart. You can see the early warning signals that have gone off up at the top of the screen. So that's not a good sign. First sign of weakness on Thursday is going to be an hourly close below 1537.15. For the NASDAQ 100, an hourly close below 2786.60 would give us a new intraday sell signal on Thursday. Okay, folks, that's all for Thursday morning. Looks like futures want to open up a little higher this morning. They've pulled off their highs that I saw when I started the presentation. I honestly don't have a bullish bone in my body right now. We could continue to trade higher from here, but this is not the time and place to put new money in the stock market. There are always trading opportunities, both bullish and bearish, on any given day. So for short-term traders, you know, one day for you is the same as any other day. For long-term investors, this is certainly not the time and place to put money in the stock market. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.